But first, let us look at examples of the three kinds of semantic categories that by may point to. So here is a sentence in which by points to an agent that was written by Ashok. Actually, this particular sentence was written by David. The second sentence, David went to New York by train. Here, by is pointing to a conveyance. David stood by the statue. Here, by is pointing to a location, by the statue. So while use of the word by helped us in that it constrained the interpretation of Ashok to either an agent, conveyance, or location, it by itself doesn't tell us whether Ashok is an agent or a conveyance or location. We need some additional knowledge. Let us suppose that the agent has an ontology of the world. The term ontology initially comes from philosophy, where it means the nature of reality. In artificial intelligence, the term ontology often refers to the conceptualization of the world, the categories in terms of which I specify the world. These categories then become the vocabulary of the knowledge representation. So let us suppose that the agent has this ontology of the world. The world is composed of things, and things can be agents or objects or locations. Agents are people, and Ashok and David are examples of agents. Objects can be conveyances, and trains and cars are examples of conveyances. Obviously, this is a very small part of someone's ontology about the world. Now, this ontology helps us decide that Ashok in the first sentence is an agent. Let's see how. Here we have by Ashok, and we know from the propositional constraints that by can refer to an agent, conveyance, or location. So the question now becomes, is Ashok an agent, Ashok a conveyance, or Ashok a location? We can look into this ontology. Ashok is people, which is an agent. So now we know that Ashok must be an agent. Similarly, the second sentence, train can be an agent, conveyance, or location. Let's look at our ontology. A train is a conveyance. So now we know the train is a conveyance. Similarly for statue. Statue in this case specifies a location. Note that this analysis applies to different propositions, not just to by. Supposing this first sentence was that was written with Ashok, in which case this proposition with will point to Ashok either being a co-agent or being an instrument. So again, we now know that Ashok is a co-agent in this sentence which contained the proposition with. There is another important thing to note here. Initially, when we were given the sentence, David went to New York by train, we started doing bottom-up processing. David was a noun, went was a verb, but pretty soon we shifted to top-down processing. As an example, we already have this background knowledge, and this background knowledge tells us in a top-down manner that by here can refer to an agent, a conveyance, or a location. We also have this additional background knowledge, and this background knowledge tells us that in this particular sentence, the train is referring to a conveyance because train is a conveyance in this ontology. So low-level bottom-up processing generates cues, which acts as probes into memory. Memory then returns knowledge like this, and the processing becomes top-down. The top-down processing tells us how to interpret the various words in the sentence, how to make sense of this story.